for changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage,
we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault-Tec, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family. have been tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Stay fed, stay hydrated. Very important. Be on constant alert for the clickety-click of your Pip-Boy's built-in radiation meter. Terrifying, leaving this warm, secure vault for a hostile wilderness with no running. Outside, survival will be easy with your construction and assembly mobile platform, or CAP. So catchy. Thank you. Overseer said she'd set up her camp down the road to the south.
please enjoy this complimentary sample of wood. Lumberjack, Protectron cuts down trees, but does not require much more lemon trees. Plus, Lumberjack, Protectron equals survivable wood. protect, and serve.
Overseer's log, south of Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remember, but... mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in... what I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault Tech was prepared. You see this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
today on the farm.
Three sets of 12 reps. Let's see. Dumbbell bicep curls, tricep extensions, and back extensions, yeah. Little peeve about the lack of proper equipment. No bother. Chin up. Only 8 more luxury coffins to make quota in backwards. Flat. Fuck financial situation around here. Just need to remind them of our friends the Chinese. I'll be back on the plane to Ipswich within a fortnight. Gather it'll be the bench press today. Yeah, again.
Hi. What do you want me to say exactly? Yeah, so just talk about how you got here and maybe a little bit about your life. This is a historic document. Go ahead, Tabitha. Okay, so, well, thanks. Okay. Whew. I've been sober. 9 days. I got here 9 days ago. My name is Tabitha, and this is my story. I just found out about everything. The war, the bombs, I just realized this was really happening. For years, I thought the cans were playing tricks with my mind, hurting my brain. I thought it was the worst trip ever. Every time I'd come out of my haze long enough to look for food, I'd buy more cans and, well, they kept going. And I kept seeing madness. Look, I would have been wandering around fighting giant rats and eating garbage if not for my mom. They're good folks. That doc in the church, got me some meds that are helping out a lot. And they have group therapy meetings, and it's good. It's good. I think it's helping. But listen, you should avoid the mountains. They'll just get you mixed up. Get you doing things you don't want to do. Hurting people mostly. And there are so many chems up there. I spent too long there, and when I feel better, I'm going out west now. Getting out of this place. Getting out, getting away from the cams, all of this. I feel better every day, but, you know, years of cams, years of rads, years of sleeping in the muck. It adds up.
Okay. Thanks for sharing your story, Tabitha. Get some sleep. You'll be okay. You're safe now.
Thank you. responders. The Mr. Fanhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians and take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
Overseer's log, town of Flatwood. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations, we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice. Angry. Tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their
It sure is great to see living human beings again. Hey, volunteer, if you need supplies, Bob's got you covered. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two? With smart and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. It sure is great to see living human beings again. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two? Hey, volunteer, if you need supplies, Bob's got you covered. Thank you. with smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. Hey, volunteer, if you need supplies, Bob's got you covered.
us all to document our stories for posterity, you know. Seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoka, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to summon a circuitry in an old video, and we tuned into a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoka to Flatwood. It was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. The responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone. Open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Reverend Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrongs. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly. And I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
full belly. Sure beats an empty one.
Level 2 nuclear alert. Repeat, this is a level 2 nuclear alert. Poseidon Energy Plant WV-06 has suffered a critical failure. Hazmat teams are en route. Please remain indoors and await further instructions.
Together.
2 nuclear alert. Repeat, this is a level 2 nuclear alert. Poseidon Energy Plant WV-06 has suffered a critical failure. Hazmat teams are en route. Please remain indoors and await further instructions.
Thank you.